We thought it would be fitting to take one last look back at some of the year's biggest winners and losers. I'm back with our roundtable, Heidi Presbola, Mark Murray, and Jason Johnson. All right, Jason, I'm going to start with you. Biggest winner and biggest loser of 2016.
Biggest winner, Vladimir Putin. He did it. He did what Gorbachev couldn't do. He did what Castro couldn't do. He basically took over the United States and got himself a Manchurian candidate. And that is something that no other Russian leader has been able to do. And he'll be cheering about this, and this will be in history books for the next 50 years.
No, it's amazing. Russia emerging as the global hegemon after we defeated them in the Cold War is shocking.
Exactly.
With the support of Republicans.
With the support of Republicans and with the support of our brand new president-elect.
Yeah. Biggest loser.
Kanye West.
And I know it doesn't seem entirely political, but Wongley was, so he starts the year with Life of Pablo. It seems like it's fine. But the problem is he exemplifies what happens when you try and mix pop culture and politics and make the wrong decisions. He came out against Black Lives Matter. He said that racism is bad. And now he's allied himself with Trump, had to cancel concerts. People don't respect him. People don't like him. He may be the only person performing at the inauguration. This is a year that shows you keep your politics and your pop culture separate.
Well, and also remember that hip hop's origins was always about fighting injustice and being on the side of progressive change, not on the side of Donald Trump.
I say biggest winner is Michelle Obama, just because I cannot imagine what an excruciating experience this must be for her.
Biggest loser?
Chris Christie. Just on every level.
Heidi is correct. There is no bigger loser in political life than one Chris Christie anywhere. And Michelle Obama is the biggest winner.